In this video, I'm going to share with you my tips on how to get more out of your GoPro Hero 8 Black and some features that could really help you out. Let's go! Hi and welcome to GoPro and Explore. If this is your first time here on this channel and you like everything about GoPro related stuff, start now by subscribing so you don't miss anything. So the GoPro Hero 8 Black has already been released for a while now and you've probably had a lot of time to test it out. Now there may still be some key features and tricks that you may not have heard about that could really help you to improve your next videos. I'm happy to share some of my tips today that could really help you to know your GoPro even better in the future. The first tip that I like to share with you is do not forget the 4:3 aspect ratio on your GoPro camera. As you make all kinds of videos, you have probably noticed that working in the 16:9 aspect ratio is the most easiest one because it's the standard ratio of YouTube. But for example, if you also want to share your video on Instagram stories, you'll really struggle as you will have to crop your video, and that could really ruin your footage and quality. So by filming in the 4:3 aspect ratio, your vertical videos will look much better. You can of course also film by holding your GoPro vertically, but you will not be able to use those shots in landscape mode afterwards. Now, I don't really use the 4:3 aspect ratio because I only make videos for YouTube, but keep it in mind. Now, before talking about the next tip, I want to remind you that I have a special playlist from Zero to Hero where you can find all my GoPro tutorials and reviews, which will be linked in this corner. The next tip is for all GoPro users. Most people, they will buy a GoPro camera and they will buy just one GoPro accessory and they will stick with the same views for a lot of time. Now, that's perfect to start with, but as soon as you want to make some more cool videos, especially sports videos, you want to try out different angles. Now, I have a good example here in this video where I use a wrist strap that you can also use on your leg. I was doing some skiing last time and I tried out various angles. And the result is pretty nice, so I really invite you to test it out and don't be afraid to think outside of the box. You've probably noticed that there is a small screen on the front of your GoPro camera, but honestly, have you really been using it so far? This small screen is pretty cool because you can see the battery level, the storage capacity and your resolution and frame rate. Now, this is really useful if you are, for example, taking a selfie, vlogging, or even when your screen is just locked and you don't want to waste time and battery life to turn on your screen just to see all the important information. Now, this technical tip will probably remind you of some bad moments when your GoPro had a frozen screen. Now, what most people do, and what I also did before, was to just remove the battery from your GoPro to get it restarted. But for some reasons, your battery can't be removed if you have dirty hands or even when your GoPro is mounted. If you are shooting underwater, it's completely impossible to take it out. But I've never tried it before. I don't think your battery will be happy with that. So to restart your GoPro, simply hold the mode and shutter button for around 5 seconds and you should be fine. The last tip I want to talk about is not really a technical tip, but something that I've learned over the years while getting the most out of my GoPro camera on holiday. Now, when you know that you're going to travel, it is not bad to do some research about the sightseeing you're going to do, the activities and everything else, because that will really help you to plan your video in advance and to get a better travel video or a better story like GoPro tells us. If you are going to London, for example, you probably know what kind of places you are going to visit. And in that way, you can already think about the footage that you want at Buckingham Palace, for example. If you are going to the London Eye, you will probably go once on it, so it's really important to think already about the footage you want on that place. Do you want a time lapse? Do you want a hyperlapse? Do you want a slow motion? And you will see that in that way, you will waste much less time when it really, really matters. And you will be even more happy with your travel video afterwards. So I hope these tips will be helpful for you. If they are, please leave a like. Make sure to let me know in the comments which tip is your favorite and don't forget to subscribe if you like anything about GoPro related stuff. I see you in the next video.